You may have been wondering, why do integrals always have that dx at the end? And what is that dx anyway? Well, there are a few answers to that question. Just like with anything else in math, your understanding of dx will get more and more complete as you get to higher and higher levels of math. A simplified, incomplete understanding of dx might serve you best when you're just starting out with integrals, but you'll need a more accurate understanding as you go along. So let's start with the simplest answer and then peel away the first few layers of the onion. Answer number one, dx is just notation. In other words, the integral symbol and the dx are like bookends that frame the function that's supposed to be integrated. That function in the middle is called the integrand, by the way. Basically, the integral symbol and the dx just work together to say, integrate whatever's between us. Answer number two, the dx tells you which variable to integrate. If it's a dx, you're supposed to integrate with respect to x. If you had a dt instead, then you'd integrate with respect to t. In other words, the integral symbol tells you to integrate the function, and the dx tells you to do so with respect to the variable x. That's why the variable in the integrand usually matches the variable in the dx, or dt, or d anything. Now you might ask, why do I need the dx to tell me which variable to integrate when the function only has an x in it in the first place? Great question, and you're right. In single variable calculus, the dx or dt or d whatever feels a little irrelevant because if there's only one variable in the integrand, then you already know which variable to integrate. It's pretty obvious that you would integrate f of x with respect to x, f of t with respect to t, or f of theta with respect to theta. But here's why it's going to matter later. When you get to multivariable calculus and you have more than one variable inside the function, you'll need to know which variable to integrate, and that dx or dt or dy will be an absolute necessity. As an example, this double integral is telling you to integrate first with respect to y, and then later with respect to x. Answer number three, the hardest but best answer. Dx is a differential, which means that it represents the difference between two things. So more specifically, it represents the distance between two values of x. But while capital DX is usually used to represent any distance, large or small, lowercase dx is what we use to specifically represent an infinitely small distance between two x values. In other words, the distance between two x values that are so close together, you can barely tell them apart. For some of you, this might be yesterday, but think back to whenever you learned different methods for approximating the area under a curve, like Riemann sums and trapezoidal rule. Those rules used a bunch of rectangles or trapezoids to approximate the area under the curve. You just find the area of each rectangle and then add all those areas together. Those methods rely on a consistent width for each rectangle. That width is called delta x, and delta x is just the distance between each x value. So what happens to delta x when we want to try to find exact area instead of just an estimation? Well, the integral is what's going to give us exact area, but the reason it gives exact area is because we change delta x to dx when we switch from the sum to the integral. Where delta x was the width of a rectangle, using dx instead of delta x makes the width of each rectangle infinitely small. Since the dx is the only thing that makes those rectangles infinitely thin, it's the only way for us to get exact area, which is why when you take the integral and you're finding exact area, it always has to be accompanied by that dx. Could you use some extra help with math? Click the button to head over to calculusexpert.com. It's where I've collected and organized all of my best resources, including exclusive videos, notes, quizzes, and even formula sheets. It's the perfect resource whether you're struggling, or if you want to take your learning further, or even if you just want to save yourself some time studying. So check it out, because I know it'll help.